I've been an artist already dedicated for 30 some years, which I dedicated just working on art. That means my language, my interpretation of colors. This is where you, I welcome you into the side of the artist. You, here you get to talk to the colors on my side. You know, you and the colors become friends. Which one's your closest friend? Which one doesn't listen to you? The colors become actually personalities, because that's how you build your piece, whatever you're working on. Now, that's a little introduction about a little bit about me. Now let's bring it out to how I kind of put this together to teach in 4 or 5 steps. We're going to create different layers for our painting. And I do this in elementary, I do it in high school, and it's something that it's the most common thing to do. Now, I'm going to start with a little disclosure. This is my background that I want to show you, my landscape that I have at my house. It's a lot of greens and some purple. Now, for a landscape, this is an outdoor landscape. This is plain air. Plain air. You're outside, you're enjoying, you pick your site. This is mine. It's going to be really hard for you to see this site. I'm going to have it open so you can. If you have a big enough screen and you're comfortable, there's the shot is going to be that one. Now, if you can't see it and you're able to go outside and pick your own, do it. This is how we, what I'm going to be talking about is the procedure and the techniques about how to get something that makes you feel good about spending 45 minutes, you know, to an hour doing it. And that'll be the things that you're going to need for this little trip that we're going to do with art. Of course, it's a canvas. So I have one already laid out right here. It's a 16 by 20 canvas. That holds acrylic. I have a panel, which it's easier for me to work outdoor. It's a panel. And what I do with this image that I get here and all these colors that I get here when I go plain air is that I bring them into the studio later on, and maybe it becomes a bigger piece, but this is my study piece. This is what I take out there so I can figure out the colors, the sunset, the movement, the shapes that I want, and then bring them into the studio. So I'm going to show you one of my the pieces that I was doing here as a study for this event that now we're having. So I made that just as a study, just as a beginning, how to figure out the depths and all that. Today, step by step, I'm going to be showing you, you know, how I came about. Even though I can do more work on it as much, you know, I still need to do on it. But this is just like a 2-hour study going back and forth so I can talk about some of the dimensions that we have here. We have the purples, the greens, the lights, and how much light is hitting. So, now that we have a little bit of our subject, if you like this subject, this little chunk right here with the purple flowers, if you can see it good and get good detail out of it, I'll give you step-by-step on this one, okay? If not, the steps that I'll be applying, I'm gonna start with a back layer and then come forward on the layers. So I'm gonna have like 4 or 5 layers when I get done with this. And the last layer is going to be the purple, the flowers. But we are going to sketch them first. We want to know where the flower is going to be, the center of the canvas. How many do you want? You want 1 flower, you want 6, you want 8. We're going to loosely sketch into it and have an idea, a map of where the colors are going to be at. And then we start with the first color that goes on the far back that most of the time is the darkest color. it's on the back. If it's a skyline and we have some hills, then the hills have the shapes and different colors, and the skyline, if it's a sunset, oranges, blues, grays. If it's just a blue skyline, then we start with a blue first, and then we add the hills. In my case back here, I'm gonna start with the darkest green on the back, the shadows behind everything, and come forward with a little lighter green, and then a lighter green, and then the last leaves will have most of the light. So that's yellows, you know, we're going to add. Also, the way that I paint, these are the brushes that I use to start my first coat, like a 2-inch brush, you know, simple 2-inch. Then for detail, I have like a pin brush. I have a 1/2-inch flat. I have a 1/2-inch angle. So then the beauty of this is we have Q-tips. Q-tips you can use when you wanna like apply paint and make these little different textures on your paint. If your paint is thick enough, we're using acrylic paint. So this is just simple acrylic, you know? It's good. It stays thick. It's the acrylic, it's not the acrylic you buy at the store for houses. It's acrylic for art. You can make with the Q-tips different shapes, different swirls, different little lines, and they stay. And then the beauty of it, you can just discard it, you know, because you don't have to go wash it and da da da. But for the ones that you can wash, there's water here. Get some water and get a rag. We're gonna need something like this, you know, to start getting all the things that we need. Paint, your brushes. If you get Q-tips, go get them. Get yourself 10 or 15. It depends how much you want to use. Because you can also group them together and they make a little cute little things, but they do work. If there's any questions about the process or anything that I have, you know, start asking them. And I'm going to start doing step by step. We picked 1.5 hours of this deal because it's recommended that you do art 45 minutes a day to feel good. Any, you know, people do their exercise and they do the body exercise, but they rarely exercise the right side of the brain, which that's my realm. Welcome to, you know, Zumba art. It's exercise for your right brain. Yes, the creative side that thinks that is part of everything, you know, that side that it's not really seen as the important one, but it's a creative side. It lets you create something that makes you feel good. At my darkest moments, like the ones we're having, it's not that I'm creating my best art. I'm not focusing on creating my best art. I'm focusing on feeling good when I make art. It's like, well, I feel my worst today. Hold on. Do I got paint or do I have, I'll go to the welder and do my sculpture. And for example, I just finished 10 mushrooms out of metal. They're like 2-3 feet high, you know, different dimensions. And on top of the mushroom, I put gardens. Why, I don't know, but it just happened now. They're along my sidewalk in my house. And mushrooms are known for healing. They have healing properties. They have medicinal. They have all these other things that I just wanted to make mushrooms to feel good. My art that makes me feel good. So I'm not doing it for right now. I'm not doing it for the, say, the art that I do at home, the 20 paintings that I'm working on, are just for me now, to feel good. So this is what I wanted to share with you guys. I'm in my backyard. This is my regular setup. With the only thing is that now instead of talking into myself, now I'm talking out into the camera to you guys, because yes, my colors that I have here, they're my friends. The brushes, I know them personally, you know, so it's like a close relationship. And you're in right now in that place that I usually create alone. With that, if there is any questions, I'm going to start preparing myself to start doing the first layer on our painting. So I'll leave it up to Laura. She's going to ask or fill in for a little bit.
Okay. I did want to just check in for a minute and say that if you have questions about materials or about kind of your setup right here today, or how you can apply the techniques Martina is using to what you are going to be doing, please message me in the chat. You can either message me privately or you can message to the group if you think it's something everyone would benefit from hearing the answer to. And I will either ask out loud to Martin if it's a question that he can answer, or if it's a question that I may just have the answer to, then I will just type a message back to you, or maybe talk a little bit again, even right now, about the materials. I do have a background in art as well, and I have experience in working in art supply stores, managing art supply stores, so I do have a pretty broad knowledge of art supplies, and I'm happy to share information and my thoughts on brands of, you know, paint and brushes and materials, or what might work best for you based on what you're doing or your kind of type of experience. I'm also aware, like we were both aware, that, you know, we're working with cameras in areas where we don't usually use cameras and trying to set up based on changing light. He was switching up his location of the easel moments before we let you all into the room. So there may be obstacles for you to see what's happening and what's working. If you're not able to see something or it's all looking washed out, let me know, and we can do our best to come up with a solution. I can't guarantee that it'll be perfect because we're learning too.
That disclosure goes for me too, because what I am going to try to explain to you about the textures, if you know it's too grainy, too far, I can turn around and see it perfectly, but you know, when I look at the screen, I can see the difference on the screen. So I'm going to get started on a white canvas, and the sketching idea, you know, I'm going to sketch it a little bit after I put, because you won't be able to see it now the way the panel sits. But I'm going to start with the main color and then sketch in something that you can see when I have a different color that you can see the sketching. Okay. So first of all, look, I picked green and black in the center right here. The tray is a little dirty, but it's green and black. So with that green and black, I'm going to make a darker green, like a forest green. And that'll be the first layer. So I'm just going to turn around and not ignoring. I can keep on talking and having that discussion even as I turn my back. So I'm not going to mix them all together. I'm going to pick up with the brush, black and green, kind of strong together. I'm not going to mix them. They're going to blend on the canvas, right? So here it goes. Half of the brush is kind of green. Half of the brush is black. And all that I'm doing, I'm making something for the back of the back. So it doesn't have to be that perfect, you know, clean, like, no, this is where you start feeling good. This is where it gives you that, I'm gonna get even with you canvas, you know? I'm pushing the brush in there. I'm letting it just be, I'm covering all the corners. I'm making sure that I cover most of the white. Well, all the white has to be covered so it looks really good. And remember, I'm only making this much of what you see here. So it's this piece from this piece to there, that little square. So I'm only working on that little square, okay? So just with the paint that I have now, I'm gonna spread it all the way around. I'm going to pull it, slide it all the way down. All we want to make is kind of a, the whole piece darker. So when we make the little leaves pop out. You know, they look cute. The sun is hitting them. I'm going to put a little bit of, I ran out of green, of course. I'm always running out of paints because they're my favorite thing to do right now. It's so easy. I can get my emotions stuck to a canvas. You know, I was talking about these bad times. These bad times can be taken out onto a canvas and left there. The bad feelings that I get, they go into a canvas and I leave them there. I have sculptures for all the things. I was diagnosed as a dyslexic in my 30s, and I didn't know what that was. I thought it was a bad thing, and I go, wait, am I going to die soon? And then I got all the information that I needed. I educated myself about dyslexia and come to find out that it was the best gift that I could have ever gotten. That's what activated my right brain. And because that's the way that I communicate with people, by drawings, the paintings, the sculptures, the art, all this stuff. Love all the arts, love the music, love cocina, cooking, todo. It's an una artes, forma artesana de trabajar. So si hacen todo su trabajo, I'm talking in Spanish and English, because one of the things that makes me really comfortable is talking Spanish, because that's the language as a baby that I had. But let me get myself back into the deal here. This is what actually makes me feel good. You know, pushing the paint around, moving the paint around, all that stuff makes your body, like, put everything that they feel, all the muscles, whatever they feel, everything you're feeling goes into the canvas. So that's the difference between a lot of the artists that I know, that the difference between us is how much trauma you have lived and survived and how much trauma you're expressing on your paintings. And those have been some of the best painters have survived most of their trauma, and they're able to put it on canvas, and other people have been able to understand what it means, because they look at it and it means something that they're aware of. As I go with the background of the canvas, I'm adding some blotches of green and pushing them in, because now I'm creating dimensions. So this is the landscape idea here. The first dimension of it, the first layer, is kind of the darkest green. That's the first one. It's right up there. And that is right behind all the stuff back here. That's the darkest in there. So now I'm adding just regular green. So just regular green. And what I do, before it gets completely dry, I just add blotches, because this is still, I'm creating like little windows of light in between each of the layers. So the first layer is dark, and then the second one is lighter. So it's just like little windows, so you can see right through to the back, okay? So before it gets all really dry back here, I'm already starting to blend it in a little. Like I said, little windows, and just smooth them out, still using my 2-inch brush, okay? Just smooth out the area, because the texture is gonna come in next. When you start adding the little leaves, that we're going to be adding, there's tricks, there's ways there's techniques that you can work with. One of the tricks is go get yourself a leaf. Go get 20 leaves, different sizes, and get ready to paint the backs and use them as stamps. Feel comfortable working with whatever kind of art you want to do. I have my way of painting is layering paint. I layer paint. I'll put one paint on top of the other and try to make texture as I make the piece. I don't like very flat paintings, you know. But my technique is layering. I layer on top of layer and create texture and create that little, capture that little light naturally. There's the real smooth technique. I mean, this is up to whoever is doing the work here. If you have any kind of experience, or you, by the way, if you don't have the materials that we have, everything that you have is welcome into this. Crayolas, Sharpies, markers, whatever you have, bring them into the thing. Okay, this is not a, oh my God, I gotta, no, don't worry about it. I use anything I can get my hands on to make art. So getting back to the painting, I was just giving it a little drying time. Okay, so now it's like good enough for me to make a little decision where the flowers are going to be. So I have a white little marker. Well, it's like a beige marker, but I'm using something lighter. So now you can see the drawing back, because I tried with my pencil, and it earlier the camera would not pick it up. So I'm going to reverse this one. And all that I want to do, because this is going to be covered anyway with paint, you're not going to see the outline, you know, I'm just using it so I can describe to you the mapping of my landscape, my outdoor free air landscape. So I'm just going to do one flower. I don't want to do the whole kind of deal. So I just want to do one flower, and they have six petals. So there's six different nice, they're different shape of petals. So here I'm just adding very lightly so I can see. Then this is just how the flower is going to sit. And then from here, I have the stalk coming in, the little vine that brings it out. On this vine, I want to make some leaves. So I'm just now, let me see, another leaf here. Here we go, another leaf. It does have a lot of leaves, so I'm going to make a lot of leaves, but not all of them. The rest are just gonna be made with different shading that we're gonna be using. It kind of represents the leaves that are back there. So we are gonna be doing some, but not all. And this, put them behind the flower. I'm putting a few behind the flower. There's just on the leaves, we just want to focus on the center. The center is the point of view. When you come into a gallery, when you go into the museum, they're always other paintings, if they're centered to your eye. So most of the time it's like 5 foot and around there, they center it to your eye. So your piece should be whatever, if you're going to have 4 or 5 of those purple flowers, you know, spread them around, have the center one. So the idea, always have the focal point. You know, this is the main conversation, is right here. So green, I have already 3 greens. And now I'm adding my idea where the flower should be. Before the flower comes about, I'm still going to add 2 or 3 more different colors of green. So then I'm going to start making the purples that I'm going to be adding to the flower. And I said purples. There's like three different purples that go into this flower. All right. So I feel good with this. I don't want to make it too much. Now I'm going to add another layer. I'm going back. I'm leaving my 2-inch brush. Bye-bye 2-inch brush. It's going back to the water jar. It's going to take a little dip. Coming into the 1-inch brush because I want to add just dabs of different greens in there. And I'm going to put a green, again, just simple green, with a little bit of brown. The next little layer is the little tan green. It's a little dirty kind of brown green. I'm not going to mix it all together. Just pick it up the same way and start putting some little blotches that I can come and smooth in a little bit. These are now creating the third layer of green. No, fourth layer of green. Fourth. So as you can tell, I'm just going around, not going where my design of the flower should be. I'm not touching that area. But now, see, I'm going to start doing something that it's now you pull the paint like in six different directions, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you leave the directions of the way you're pulling your paint. You leave tracks, you leave little lines, and it's okay. Just pull it different because back there, that little chaos of green back there, that's how it is. It's one is going one direction and the other one is going the other direction. So they capture light different. The lines, the strokes are different. So give it the same kind of idea. Give it a 6-different direction pull of your paints.
Hi, Martin. I'm going to ask a question here that someone was asking. Had some comments that people would like to get a close-up for a moment. Would you be able to move your camera closer for just a minute to your...
Yes. If you want to blink me out for a little bit, and then I'll set it to where it's close, or just drag the phone over there?
I think just dragging it close might be the better.
Okay.
That way you won't have to join again.
Here we go.
Oh, I think it might be a close-up of your canvas.
My canvas. Okay, so this is what I'm working on, and a single flower, all right? And we're coming back, and I'll switch it around. Can you guys see it? So I was working on 4 layers. This is the 4th layer. And the 4th layer of green that I added, I started pulling the strokes in 6 different directions. And I always the same direction. So when like you pull it one way and then you turn your brush and you got to do the 6 and pull them around. So I'm trying to do what the leaves are mimicking behind. The leaves are one way and the others are the other way, one up, down, all the way around. So I'm just trying to create a little bit of that texture of chaos on the back, if that makes sense. With that, I did make that little light drawing of just one single flower with a bunch of leaves. I'm going to be adding the leaves, but I want to add some of this paint pulling different ways. I want to add more of those with different colors on the green. So on this green, I added some brown, but I don't mix them in together. I just pick like straight up and down with the brush onto the paint and pick up 2 different colors and take them to the canvas and pull them in different directions with a 1-inch brush. So I'm going to get back to doing the second layer, and I'll do 2 more layers and then do a close-up with it. All right? Let me see if I can get it back with the way it was. There it is. Okay, so we were working on the brown and green. Again, I'll go back to the green because this is all about green. And I'm going to add a little bit of orange, a little bit of orange. The yellow that I'm gonna be using, it's one of the last layers on the layering. And then come in some real leaves with different colors in them. The leaves are like a light sage kind of idea. So here we go again. I'm going just to do dabs. And if you want to start pulling your paint, you can, but always think of the six directions, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then repeat again. You know, just switch your hand around. Don't cover all the dark. We need some of the dark spaces on the back. Okay. So this is again just doing some filling in. Instead of making 1,000 leaves, we're just giving the idea of so many different things behind it, you know? So some of the orange, I don't mix it in. I just pick up orange with green, and they make that different tone, different idea. If you want to leave some places darker and some lighter, hey, you know, I'm at the place that I'm looking at, which is on the shaded side, it has not that much light. So this one I promised to my daughter anyways, the painting. She's expecting it, so she's a hard client. So I'm making it for her because her deal was to make me one with one flower. She's the one that works with me when I have all this setups. Suddenly I come back to my painting and there's an added piece to it. And it's been my daughter most of the time. She's 9. She's allowed. She's a good artist. Actually, she's mentoring me on what I thought I knew of art. So we are working on our 5th layer. And again, I'm pulling paint left and right. And again, if we leave those little marks, like little streaks, it's okay. Because we're adding texture to a background. Right now, I'm just going over all the stuff and flattening it down a little bit, taking away some of the sharp little color. And see, when different colors go in, they blend in together. And they make this multi-layering look so different, you know, unplanned. Just unplanned. It's like, this is the beautiful thing about chaos. It's turning into not chaos. It's organized chaos. Colors, canvas, me, you guys, having this energy all working together, especially in these times, again. we're all living something that it's not real yet. You know, I'm trying to make art about this time and the things that I would do, and they even scare me. So I don't want to even do that. I'd rather do flowers and do this thing than go into my sculpture. My sculpture it's to tell you something. You know, my painting is to share. With sculpture, I want to show you. I want to put it in your face. With painting, no, this is my soft side. this is the side that helps my inner self stay grounded. This gets me ready for do the sculpture deal. So now on the last layer, we're going to just put on the green. I have some green left over. I'm going to put a little bit of yellow, like a little tiny dab of yellow. Not a lot. We don't want to make it too bright. But I have like 2/4 like the area of two quarters with green, and I'm going to put the area of a penny with yellow. Okay. And we use quarter and pennies, and we use that because it's the simplest thing for anybody to kind of, a penny, that size. So see, pennies worth like two quarters, two round. Still, I'm just going to pick up like this, the paint. I'm not mixing them in. We'll blend them in later. So just pick up like that. The same thing, try to do them in different directions because you're picking up yellow with one side and the other one is green. So when you do this way and then you do that way, yellow's on top, yellow's on the bottom, okay? I'll be showing you in the close-up in a little bit. So the yellow, it's just the spots that are getting the most light, and the yellow is the one that is on the very top of all this kind of make-believe of leaves that is happening back there. We're not making real leaves, we're just making the little shadow deal about the leaves. So here we are.
Hi, Martín.
Yes.
I'm gonna ask a question for someone to confirm because I don't think it's been visible. Are you washing your brushes when you switch colors, or are you sort of wiping and letting some of those colors blend?
I don't wash brushes. I keep them moist till the brush gets really hard, and then I dunk it in. My 2-inch brush that I was using, because I am working outdoor, it dries a lot quicker. I always, the way that I work myself by layering paint, so I just use this like a knife to pick up paint and put in there. So my technique of layering is leaving as much paint on the canvas without dripping it. Mm-hmm. If I can, so that makes the textures that I wanna see. So yes, I don't wash them. I just pick up paint and keep on going, keep on paint. And because I am working with the backgrounds, which they all have the similar green effect, so at the end, you have the perfect green on your brush at the end of everything. Then on the purples, I do switch brushes because that's more detail that I'll be having on the front. I'll be doing different, I'll be washing my brush for the greens that I'm going to be doing on the leaves because they're the front pieces. The leaves and the flower are going to be the last layer. Those I have to detail more. And I want my texture only to be on the flower and the leaves. So this, what I'm doing is layering. So that's why I'm pulling it so it's flatter. I just want on the background of this painting that I'm doing to have the dimension of the darkest to the lightest and have some depth in there. And then have the flower be right on front. Yeah. So before my paint dries, I gotta do some pulling myself here, and I'll bring in the close up right now so you guys can see the effect that the same green, but I added three different other five different other colors into the game of the greens here.
Can I interrupt now, just because I have a observation that I think others might like to hear too, that I think when you're looking at his canvas, you can really start to see that he's not just sort of on a whim picking different greens and putting them in. Like I can see him working on the canvas and I can see the background that he's painting, and you see those bright light green specks or sort of patches that he's blending. And those really are the same tone as all the really bright, almost washed out highlights on the plants that you see in the sun.
Yes, and see, I'm going over my, I don't want the leaves and the flower just to be like surrounded with these colors. No, I have my perfect color of greens all and mixed on the same brush, I'm kind of going over what I sketched. And this is the part that I told you it would get erased anyways. So I want to go over because I want to make things under the leaf. So I want the color that I'm using that looks like it went under the leaf and the leaf is on top of it. So for example, this little thing here, I'm just going to go over it. I can still see the outline, but now there's a layer on the top of it, and this is going to look like it's on top. I'm going to do a few more before my paint dries, and then I'll bring in the close-up so you guys can see the getting ready for this deal.
I'm also just going to send a little reminder that we are getting close to 12 o'clock already. Time's flying.
Yes.
Just for your own kind of process.
And this is one of the things, an exercise like this on a piece like this, a 16 by 20, it takes time. It's not for you. When I'm done, you did the primary, you did the first detail, go into detail mode, you know? And it, the piece I can take a picture of the flower deal and send it to Laura. That way she can put it up on the line. So if you guys want to just use it as reference, after we're done, it'll be up there.
Yes, I will be following up with everyone, hopefully sending this recording so that you can kind of remind yourself of what he talked about in the class. And that way, if you didn't quite get to one of the steps or you want to revisit some part of it, you have that as a reference too.
Okay, let's do a close-up of the greens before I start doing the flowers. And I mean the flower and the leaf, okay? So now I gave it that effect of I want to make the flower to float, you know? I want it to look like it's floating away from all the green and the chaos. So I added all this little stuff around it. We had the darkest, which is still back here. I haven't put any green there. And then we added a little darker green. And then we added the brown with the green. Then we added the orange with the green. And then we added the yellow with the green. So see, now I'm just trying to give it a nice kind of area of leaves, but not making the leaves. So these little, all the other colors and the different way the paint is pulled, that's giving the effect of a busy background. Okay, let's get back here. So now we are going to go into the purples, and going into the purple, I like to do the same idea, put two paints side by side. So I'm going to use white and purple. Two dabs, the size of a quarter each on one area. And we're going to use that half inch, kind of flat half inch from either side. And the first thing that we're going to do is put the paint on, okay? For that, what I'm going to do, I will get myself out of the image and put it real close so you can see the amount and how the paint is playing. So I'll put it as a close-up for the canvas, and you'll be able to see my hands and maybe some of the how it layers and how I like to layer colors in there. So, meanwhile, Laura, you go ahead. I'll set up. You keep them entertained.
Yes.
And I'm back.
Yay.
I got some purple and some white. I got my flat brush. It's half inch, just flat. I mean, a round works good too, but for me, the sharp edge is important. So I'm going to pick up half and half, half purple, half white, half purple, half white, and go into the flower and just pull one pull all the way down. Purple and white again. Go to the other side. Pull all the way down. Don't make up and down strokes. And now we close it. We're going closer. This is the first layer of the flower. I like that white.
I'm going to barge in one more time here before you get going. Another really good observation sent to me, and that is that for folks who are inside painting and not in the bright sun, their paint is drying a lot slower. And yes. So while there's not that much we can do about that here, we're going to be in different spaces. You want to mention that as you are working, just that, you know, some people will have to be more careful with how much paint is on their canvas and might have to take a little more time before moving on to this step.
So on the bottom one, Laura, is it, like, for me, is drying really fast because I'm putting real thin layers. And as you can tell, it's dry already. I'm outside. But now for this last one, because I can leave it setting there for an hour and dry, I'm picking up a lot of paint on the brush, a lot. So it doesn't fall, but I'm picking a lot of paint. So what I do, I try to make the shape, the veins of the flowers as I drag it, because they do have folding shapes. So I'll show you how, maybe it'll pick it up as I do it. But I turn the brush and I give it this lighter color because that's where the sun is supposed to be hitting. So the straight edge is for this reason. I want to make the straight line over here on top. And it's leaving like a vein, a thick little pile of paint. So I'm leaving those because, like I said at the beginning, I want to make it seem like the flower is really there. So I'm giving it a thick coat to separate itself from the greens. The color purple already separates enough, but then we add texture to it. Remember my client, my 9-year-old client, she wants it like that. So here I go to the other, and I'm going right over the line that I made. And I also twist all that I'm doing. I'm not messing around with anything else. I want to just add the first big, thick layer of paint. Okay. First big thick layer of paint. And then I'll come back and fill in the rest. On this deal, on the indoor, how you guys are indoor, and it's kind of, I know it's hard being indoor. We've been indoor for a lot. If you're painting on a flat surface and you're painting, like you're painting flat, it's not upright, it's better for this little last deal, because just put paint, don't smush it together. Leave the little lines, leave the little white, leave those, add more. To the last deal, you add thickness of it. And you'll see, it surprises you when you see it, like when it's dry and it's hanging somewhere, you're like, whoa, it does pop out, you know? And I'm working on that, making something that comes all the way out. The same thing that we would do for a big landscape, you know, miles apart. You see the hills, you see the sunset. Same, we do that dimension deal all the way across. So I gotta keep on going because I got my paints almost getting to the point where they become a little gloopy, and I don't want it to be gloopy. So now I did the first line, I go back. And as you can tell, I'm just adding paint, adding. I'll come in detail in a little bit. I don't know if we have enough time, but then I'll start. Okay, the center, it's more like I want to use most of the purple on the filling in of the piece. So that's only like most of the purple, because there's a darker purple in there too, see? And the brush, it holds different colors. So for example, this petal right here, I wanna fold it. So there's like a crease in the middle. So I pick up right here, give it like a little folder. See? I can see my detail, of course, very clearly here, and it's hard for you guys to do that, but I'm trying to do that little, I'll show you a little close up in a little bit. So one of the best things that I get from doing art is feeling good. This part right now, I hold my breath to do it. I'm like all panicky. I'm all excited to do this little piece, just to show you that how before, you know, I always did everything very like pushed all the paint in there. And then as I started getting all this how to paint idea, I kept on seeing a lot of texture. So I was missing the texture by just pushing the paint out there. I was missing half of the experience of doing art like this, because man, you start doing paint texture, and for me, it's doing sculpture at the same time. So how the flowers come about here, most of them have, and the petal have a center. So now I'm just adding like a straight line in the center, like a straight line. That's the kind of data. Any questions about this layering? See, I want to give it a little bit of, for me, if I start working on the leaves right now, I can come back to this, and by that time it's semi-dry, then I can add another tiny layer. I got to do the center of the flower, which is mostly white. And then I got to add the center of the flower, which is, let me show you one. So this is the flower. And as you turn it, it picks up different colors. As I turn it into the light, it picks up dark. If I turn it into a dark, you know, it's just, the colors are different. Mine, I'm making it dramatic, accenting, I accent everything that I see, all the kind of lines I accent, I make it more dramatic. I want it to speak loud. So this is the beautiful flower I have here at the garden, that this now, it's kind of that. So I need to work on the center, that guy. So I'm gonna let it dry for a little bit and then start making some of the leaves so you can see the leaves, because you know, one of the things is that we're running out of time. This time I am washing my brush. And there comes in the rag. You dry it with your rag. So then for the green, for the leaves, I'm going to use a turquoise kind of green. A little bit of the turquoise green. Because for the leaves, it doesn't take much. A little bit of turquoise green, some of the original green that we have, which is this guy right here. Okay. And let me see, a little bit of the white. We're trying to make this kind of lavender kind of color. So it's like a little three little mix, green, white, and turquoise. And pick it up in different, just dip and come to the, and here we just want to cover the first layer of the leaf is painted it in. So try to leave the accents that you pick up when you dip into your three colors. Leave them in there. That's the first layer of the leaf that we have. We're putting this light kind of lavender on it, so it really stands out away from the other greens. And it becomes very out front. This lavender, most of the time, this turquoise cancels a lot of the other colors. It's crazy. So I'm gonna fill in on leaves, and on leaves, I did like 10. No, I'm gonna put like 15 more. And the little vine where it goes, and the little out, they're gonna be later with a little bit of brown, of course. But here, let me see, 15. By the way, I'm left-handed. Most of the artists are left-handed. Some, you know, the ones I know. This, I don't know what it is, but we have that. If you're right-branded, you're left-handed. If you're right-branded, you're left-branded. So it's something like that. So I have that many leaves. I want to make one side of the leaf different than the other, okay? So I come back and add more color on one side of the leaf, more than the other. So that way you identify half of the leaf. So add different color. If you have kind of turquoise, add some more of the green and go half of the leaf. If not, if it's already too dark, put some of the white and go half of the leaf, half. I have. Now, I said I was going to make some more leaves. I'm going to add like 6 more. Client's order. Here we go. I'm going to give you guys a close-up right now. It's for the next time, I promise you, we'll probably have like a whole team. If this is something that you guys like. Now, again, I mean, I am layering paint, like making it thick. So, because on the next layer, I want to put some yellow with that green on top of this, and it'll look like the it's getting hit right on front. So promise you a little close up. Let me see if, can you guys see the detail?
Yeah, that looks good.
And that kind of a thick just paint there. That's, if you look at a lot of the paintings, that's what it comes from, you know? It actually, the artist is trying to give it a dimension, so it's more in your face than anything else. So I will be moving on. So how much time do we have?
Got about 20 more minutes.
20 more minutes. That's pretty good. Mm-hmm. Okay. Here we go. I'm now going to start detailing this guy. So I'm going to be using my little pin brush, okay? So I have a little kind of pin brush and some white. So I'll go into the center. And I wanna, usually I will give it like maybe 20 or 30 minutes for this thing to be dry so I can mess with it, come and do the more the details. But here, since we are in real time, and so here we go. Now, on the brown, on the white that I have, you're going to add a little bit of brown, a little bit of brown on the white, and the same brush. Don't wash it, the same brush. So now we bring in the, little vine. So the little vines, I don't want to bring them all out because they're hiding behind the greens that I kind of layered up earlier. And so all that I'm doing is bringing them out in some little way. And before I get done with all this, like some leaves, I'm gonna make like three more, are gonna be over the vine. So I also give the vine a little like front and back, more lifelike. I'm just right now adding color to the vine idea.
Can you give us a close-up after you work on some of this? Just because your head is currently blocking our
view. Right on it. Yeah. So the fact that I'm wearing a big hat like this is because I have no hair and I don't want to get sunburned. So I will give you guys a close-up. I'm just trying to do my own little detail there. To all the leaves that I made, I am giving them a stem. And they don't have to touch anything. They just gotta have like, they got a little stem and going towards the vine. That way, they're just not lonely there by themselves. Here we go. Okay. Now I did say that now that I have this on top, I'll show you guys how to do my two bread. I'm gonna make some leaves, and then I'll give you the close up. Okay. Same deal on the leaves. I have green, turquoise, and white. So I'm gonna make one leaf like going over this piece right here, the stem. And I go one side, same, the other side, same, and they give it a pointy end. We'll detail in a little bit the rest, okay? I'll put one right, let's see, right here. Remember, I added to half of the leaf, a different color, because that gives it a little bit of capturing the light. And it's giving me the chance right now that I mix these paints to add another little layer of the other greens that I was using for the leaves. So right now that you get the close-up, you'll see more of the what I'm talking about, adding different layers. So here, let me just finish these little, because I do need yellow on those leaves. So there'll be some yellow for the sunlight. Right now, I'm just adding some of the texture light that they get from different directions. And
Martin, I know we're running kind of short on time, but would you mind taking a few moments to talk a little bit more about kind of finding your light source and seeing where the light's coming from for some of our people who are a little less experienced?
Got it. So let me see right there. I'm going to be talking, but you guys get your, let me see if you can write about there. I am using the light. It's right now, it's noon, so it's right above. And what that does, and believe it or not, the flowers follow the light. So most of the flowers that I work with, they follow the light. So at noon, they have a different, they're pointing almost straight up and trying to grab as much sun as they can get. For when I do something like a big tree, I do want to capture half of the light on the tree so I can get the dark, you know, the darker areas, and I can get the both perspectives, both sides of the same picture, the darker side to the lighter side. In the mornings, you get the best soft sunlight for more personal, romantic setting that you want to this and that, you know. In the afternoons, you get the same effect with the darker colors. You get more oranges, the grays, the blues always pop in there, but everything is more darker. During the morning, you get the lightest, more comfortable light. And the afternoons, you get that, you know, full color set of spectrum comes in the afternoons. I like to work mornings. I love mornings. Morning gives you that different light. Also, it's cooler for if you go and carry all this stuff somewhere and park yourself for, you know, a couple hours. Mornings are the best for me because of I take my coffee, my favorite pastry, and pick a good spot and imagine how life would be with your hands, you know, and you put it on a piece of canvas that later on you can remind yourself of yourself when you were seeing that image, you know, and you are actually talking to yourself about it. You don't wish that when I was teaching sixth grade, I used to hear a lot teaching art, sixth grade. I used to hear a lot of like, I'm not good enough. Oh, I don't like this. Can I have another? No. This is one of the things with art. Art, the way you make it, it's perfect. It's your art. It's your expression. It's your life. It's you. It's you. And don't be ashamed of, you know, I think sometimes that my art is not like, oh, you know, it's not going to be liked by a lot of people. And then to come to find out that I was wrong. People do like it. And then I'm like, wait, why did you guys like it? Because when I think about the things that I do, I'm not only speaking for myself at that moment, I'm also speaking for a lot of other people that feel a little bit like me. The light here that I'm using, again, it's like I shadowed myself under umbrellas this time because I didn't want to get sunburned. And half of the imagery that I'm using, the flower, half of them were on the sun and half were in the shade. I'm more like what the shade provides. But the umbrella that I'm using is yellow. So I am getting light in, and that light I'm diffusing the light that I'm using for this painting. I don't want it to be like full on yellow, so is where the sun is hitting. A more shaded, diffused light, because this piece is going to be indoor and it's going to have a light on it. So I want it to look more softly than the bright colors that everybody will get. Any questions about maybe how to have any idea of working faster or slower, or what technique should be used for your art piece?
One question I think might be beneficial to people is if you want to take these next few minutes to maybe work, really kind of hone in the detail on just like one tiny little spot, whether it's one leaf or one petal. Just so people can kind of see a little bit that's like the full kind of extent of what they might be able to do.
Let me see. Okay, let's go. Right here, I'm going to, this leaf that I have here, I'm going to load it with like green, more green than anything else. Same brush, I didn't wash it. So I'm going to try to make a middle, perfect middle for it, and then pull. Then I go back with a little bit of white and just pull. To give it those veins idea of the flower, I mean the leaf, I'm just going to do half this color, and then I want to add a little bit of like yellowish. I'll do that right now. Since we're doing one. So I just added a little bit of dab of yellow and to the white. So I'm going to pick up a tiny bit with the same brush. I'm not going to wash it, but I do want a little bit of light. So now, and my strokes are towards the front of the leaf. So I also create that kind of the veins, the little ripples of the leaf. Here, I'll do this one on the opposite side. This, so by me putting yellow on this side of the leaf, that I'm assuming that the sun is on that, the right side of the screen? On this side, the sun is hitting from this side a little bit, or stronger from this side. Like I said, it's up. So, and I got out of the leaf. I gotta go into repair mode right here. There we go. Now to this one that I just did with the yellow, I'm going to add the white. Because now I'm giving directions wherever the leaves should be. Looking up, looking down. Here we go, let me see. And again, I like to layer a lot of different paint. So it takes me like 6 to 7 hours, not all together. Like I'll do 1 hour and then come back and repeat till I have multiple layers coming out. Today on the greens by themselves, I think we did 6 layers, and then the leaf and the other leaves we're creating this dimension of landscape. So I go here with my yellow again. I'm going to add yellow to one side. Now all the yellow that is popping out accents the whole piece, and then it comes and puts together these other yellows that were back here. There we go.
I'm going to butt in really quick to say, for these, as we're kind of getting into these closer to finishing, not quite finishing touches, but more detail area, I think most people working indoors probably are not at a point when they can do this, and that is okay. Yeah. This might be a point when you just stop a little and let your paint dry and watch, because I don't want you to accidentally ruin what you've been working on.
True. Very true. Here, the layering part, I got 1, 2, 3, adding the yellows, and I change directions again. Even as I'm working here, I just add the color and then come, and then I adjust how the color runs. I make the little shapes on color because I'm still working with a lot of wet there. So I'm making, when I make the little lines, I make grooves in the paint. So that gives it also the real look of a leaf, making those directional lines, so you know which way the leaf is, yeah? Here, so I finished the other leaf with the greens and the white, so I added to this other side, and then I kinda, I'm just doing this, getting rid of whatever, and then going, getting rid of the paint, I mean, on the same plate that I have. I pick up my yellow and white, and I come back to this same leaf, and I add my yellow. The yellow, the top layer of the yellow is the direction where your sun is supposedly, you know, however you wanna. This leaf is like this looking at the sun. This one is like this. This one is up like this. So I'm trying to give it already how, which way they're facing by doing some of the yellow. The yellow is the last part of the bright light. So here we go. And already the leaf tells me the direction it's in and where is it going, because I'm at the stem going forward. I add that, I go back, pick up some white. I gotta get to the purple and do some little repair here. And now this one accents more with the white. So and then I use a very sharp corner of the brush. That's why I like this little deal to make the little lines that I want to do. I'll finish this one leaf right here. And then I'll get to the flower a little bit more. Yes.
We're at 12:30. I think there's no problem with, you know, spending another 5 minutes or so. Anyone who needs to leave, we totally understand. And we'll be following up probably on Monday. Try to not work all Sunday. So we will hear from you. You can add a comment to me still in the comments or email me with anything specific that you'd like to maybe get some more info on. I'm gonna try to share some information on some of the materials and techniques we talked about in the follow-up along with a survey, as well as we'll be sharing video. I might take a few more days after that before we get the video to you, but we will do that as well.
So here we go. I'm just going right over all the pieces now. I'm just going to put the paint that I have on my tray, on the leaves that I have, and then I can come back and start readjusting the paint the way I want it. This paint, again, the way I like this acrylic deal, it doesn't fall. It doesn't drip. It's really good. Really good paint, Laura.
Good. Yeah, it's Laura, not the worst. Paint I provided that we would have been taking to sixth grade and fifth grade classrooms.
But. I know. But, Laura, like at the beginning, she said we worked together and we've been working together to bring art to all your kids in school. And she does a great job of getting me there. And I like going to those places to share what I have about art, because I wished there was something like this when I was growing up.